this week's Torah reading has God commanding the Jewish people, you shall be holy. Let's set aside the complications of what does it mean to have God commanding holiness. Let's think about what does it mean to be holy. Elements of the tradition certainly want to define holiness as somebody who follows the mitzvot and the halakha. If you do so, you're holy. The command to be holy comes right after a long list of sexual prohibitions. And there are those who want to claim, if you follow the sexual prohibitions, you'll be holy. Ramban, Nachmanides, tells us that holiness is directly connected to moderation. The Judaism doesn't require abstinence, it requires moderation, fidelity, monogamy. Judaism says, eat to your pleasure, but do so in a way that's limited under certain criteria. Judaism says, enjoy alcohol in moderation. Judaism says, accrue wealth, but once you have that wealth, you've got to be a proper steward and distribute it properly. It's a beautiful teaching. I want to take it one step further. I'd like for you to imagine or think of the person you've ever met or known that you describe as holy. What is it about that person? Is that person a social activist? Does that person have great courage? Is that person generous? Is that person pious in their ritual observance? What I would like to claim is that the commonality of each person that we're now thinking of is humility, modesty. That is, that if you're imagining somebody who is holy, my strong inclination is to believe that that person has a certain gentility, humility, a certain quiet about her, a certain presence that makes others around her not feel threatened, despite the fact that she may have strong convictions. The beautiful element of this teaching of holiness is that it isn't predicated on a certain belief about God. It's predicated on human potential. We each have the potential and the capacity to be more modest, to be more humble, to not make others feel threatened in our presence. Being holy and being a holy people doesn't mean not having strong opinions. It doesn't mean not having conviction. It means having humility and understanding that there may be other truths, other elements, other opinions out there that also have merit and they need to be respected. Being holy, something that's within the grasp of each of us. Time to actualize it. Shabbat Shalom.